On October 14, 1947, Chuck Yeager became the first person to fly faster than the speed of sound. He and his team revolutionized air travel when they broke the sound barrier in 1947. Without the contributions of Yeager and his team, we would not be as advanced as we are today in the field of supersonic air travel. Charles Elwood Yeager was born on February 13, 1923, in Myra, West Virginia. He was later nicknamed Chuck. He graduated from Hamlin, West Virginia High School in 1941 and enlisted shortly thereafter. He was accepted to the Army Air Corps in July of 1942 for training. He was a very promising pilot and showed great potential. Yeager received his wings and was appointed to the 8th Air Force for combat operations in World War II in March of 1943. 1 year later, in 1944, his P-51 Mustang was shot down over German-occupied France. With the help of the French underground, he was able to reach safety in Spain.
In November 43, we were sent to England to 8th Air Force and received Mustangs, P-51s. And I flew quite a few missions over there, up until March of 5th, 44, and I got shot down, and that took me some 4 months to get back.
Instead of quitting, Yeager put in a request to return to combat. This request went all the way up to General Eisenhower. It was granted, and he returned to combat in August of 1944. He fought until February of 1945 when he returned to the United States. On one mission, Yeager was able to shoot down 5 German planes, including one of Germany's first fighter jets. During World War II as a whole, he flew over 60 combat missions and shot down 13 German planes. When Yeager returned to the States in February of 1945, he attended an instructor pilot course and served as an instructor pilot until July of the same year, when he received his first experimental work in Wrightfield, Ohio. His work in Ohio led to his selection as the pilot of the United States' first research rocket aircraft, the Bell X-1. Yeager was not their first or second choice, however. Jack Woolams had been chosen to be the chief test pilot for Bell aircraft in 1944. Woolams conducted the preliminary tests of the program, but his career was cut short when he was killed in a plane crash 2 years later in 1946. Soon thereafter, they hired Chalmers Goodlin. He also flew several test flights, but none of them reached speeds above Mach 1. He was removed from the project when he demanded a $150,000 bonus for achieving supersonic flight. That is equivalent to almost $2 million today. This is when Yeager was brought onto the project. The assignment was located at Muroc Air Force Base in California. Muroc has one of the longest runways in the world and is adjacent to Rogers Dry Lake. This dry lake had been used in the 30s as a bombing range to train pilots and would now serve as the location for the project. The somewhat secretive X program, also known as the X-Plane program, was run by the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, also known as the NACA. It was founded in 1915 and its job was to research, design, and test aircraft to improve aerodynamics. The NACA was an independent government agency that reported directly to the president. They were the organization responsible for the tests. The Bell X-1 was built by Bell Aircrafts. It was not your everyday plane. It was designed with very thin wings and a streamlined fuselage. The designers used the 50 caliber bullet as an inspiration for the X-1. It had a length of 31 feet and its wingspan was 28 feet. The plane used a liquid-fueled rocket engine that was designed and built by an American engineer by the name of James Hart Wild. Chuck decided to nickname the plane Glamorous Glynis in honor of his wife, Glynis. The X-1 had to be lifted to the correct altitude by a B-29 Superfortress. They constructed a special pit for the X-1 to slide into the ground so it could be attached to the bomb bay on the bottom of the B-29. Major Ezra Kocher was a key part of the operation. He became the first director of the U.S. Air Force Institute of Technology and helped to get the X-Plane program off the ground. The year is 1947. Harry Truman is president. It is 2 years after the end of World War II and the Cold War has just begun. Truman signs the National Security Act of 1947 and the CIA is founded. The microwave is a brand new invention and Ferrari is building their very first road car.
After the war, with Europe devastated, this is where the new frontiers of flying would be pushed back by some well-funded and brilliantly organized research called the X program. Within 10 years, this program would force new aircraft through the sound barrier and on to speeds of 2,000 miles an hour.
Yeager loved to have fun during the test flights and often went off script, so to speak, and did some spins and tricks here and there. Most of the time, his superiors did not appreciate his actions and he found himself in trouble more than once. But when the day finally came, he was ready. On October 14, 1947, the Bell X-1 was lifted by the B-29 to an altitude of 25,000 feet. Yeager and the B-29 team made their final plans on timing the drop, then Yeager was carefully lowered down into the X-1. The B-29 team counted down, then dropped the X-1 from the bomb bay. After being dropped, Yeager rocketed to 40,000 feet, traveling over the speed of 662 miles per hour, which was the sound barrier at that altitude.
And he does it! The first human to crack the sound barrier!
After, on the way down, when I jettisoned the rest of the fuel and spilled the domes, I knew we'd gotten above Mach 1. I think my feeling was that this program is finished. I can get on with the rest of them. It was one of many, you know. And it didn't mean anything, as people said later on in life. I didn't realize what it meant to the Air Force.
The X program had just made history. It was the first manned flight to reach speeds over Mach 1. Many congratulations were to follow, but due to the secrecy of the project, it was not released to the public until several months later, in June of 1948. People were awed by the accomplishment, and Chuck gained much popularity. He received the McKay Trophy and the Collier Trophy in 1948, and that year he was also awarded with an honorary Doctor of Science degree from West Virginia University. Chuck continued to work with the Air Force, and in 1953, he flew an X-1A rocket plane at speeds of up to 1,650 miles an hour. In 1969, Yeager was promoted to the title of Brigadier General and later retired in 1975. 4 years later, in 1979, the publication of Tom Wolfe's book, The Right Stuff, made Yeager into an international celebrity. In 1983, a motion picture based off the book was released, and Chuck once again came into the public eye. He has flown over Mach 1 several times since his retirement to commemorate his achievements. Today, he resides in Pin Valley, California, and runs the General Chuck Yeager Foundation, which supports today's youth. Bell X-1 had a major impact on jets and paved the way for air travel above Mach 1. Without it, today's fighter jets might not have supersonic capabilities. It forever changed the way we view supersonic flight and gave inspiration for many future planes. The Bell X-1 directly impacted the X program and was used as a model to create later X planes. It was the first in a series of planes that would break the barriers of aviation around the world. Today, the Bell X-1 is on display at the Smithsonian Institution's National Air and Space Museum in Washington, D.C. The X program continued for many years and has created many more supersonic planes. Last but not least, the NACA officially turned over its operations to NASA on October 1st, 1958. Yeager and his team revolutionized air travel when they broke the sound barrier in 1947. They paved the way for the first manned flight above Mach 1 and forever changed how we view supersonic flight. Without their contributions, we would not be as advanced as we are today in the field of supersonic air travel.